With a wonderful follow-up interview that we did just a few weeks ago. And it's with an entrepreneur, Ryan McMullen. And it's not so much the entrepreneurship that I want to get into today. That was wonderful last time. But today I want to get into why so many of you are praising that last interview. So Ronnie, welcome back to the show. How are you doing?
Good. How are you doing, Josh?
Oh, I'm good. I'm really good. As a matter of fact, since our interview, I've had a number of people who have tried your product, and they said, hey, you know, I never heard about this before. I wanted to see what it was all about. I tried it and loved it. I'm assuming that is not something that is new to you. So kind of tell us that whole process. When somebody tries your product, they get an experience, but it's an experience that many of them don't associate with a beverage that they drink.
Well, first of all, the beverages that we get in the grocery store, and I'm not dogging them, but many of them are not good for us. Even the ones that say they're good for us are all not that good for us, because anytime you turn that label around and you see sugar, sugar's a toxin. So you're not doing good. Now, some of them have less sugars and they might have some kind of this tea or that tea. And then we have the major soda drinks and the soft drinks, and they have so much garbage like corn fructose, whatever. So when you get mine is kind of funny because mine doesn't come to you in a can or a bottle. It comes in a package and you got to brew it. So you got to kind of work for it, which is a kind of an interesting aspect. But I always kind of give people the idea like, okay, my tea is something you make right before you're at the bottom of a mountain and you're going to do this spiritual hike and you're going to get some really powerful stuff. I kind of put it that way. It's like a Native American tea, and it's not, but that's kind of the idea. You brew it, you drink it, and what it does for you. And people don't realize until they have, as you said, the experience. That's kind of great wording. I might steal that. But they have this experience and they find out that, hey, this is cleaning the system. This is making me feel better. I'm having energy. And they don't receive that stuff from the grocery store when they buy those drinks. They get something that tastes good. Ooh, this tastes good. But, you know, we can go to some of the burger stands and it tastes good. But is it really good for us? And is our body recognizing it as food? And that's the key, is our body knows what's good for us and knows what's not. We just have to start watching the signs.
You know, that's so true, because even recently, some of these larger brands, and I think Naked Juice was one of them, kind of came out as you know, it's not as precise as what the label leads us to believe. And I think that they can make the product, we have the freedom to buy it and sell it, but we have to inform ourselves as to what we're really buying. And with all this movement towards vegan and towards, you know, plant-based diets or even paleo diets, people are asking themselves, what do I do? Because we want to be healthier. What sort of role does the tea play in not only that movement, but in a diet?
Well, to me, the tea is absolutely, it's our flagship of our website. I mean, that's why our website's called Get the Tea. It doesn't say get the supplements. It says get the tea. The tea is the flagship because we have intruders today. We have stuff that's getting in our system from our air, from our water, from our foods, from GMOs. We can go on and on and on. I mean, we literally have intruders from every angle. So this tea, if you drink it every month, every day, it is a mild detox, which will clean you of parasites, heavy metals, garbage. So basically, it's not like, and at first people buy it and they go, oh, I had a bathroom effect. And I didn't like it. Well, you need to like it, because when you have the bathroom effect, everything that's bad for you is coming out of you. It's exiting you, which means it's kind of like cleaning your house. You got rid of all the dirt and all the dust, so you're gonna breathe better. So when you clean your body, and what happens is after about 3 or 4 days, then you don't have those bathroom events, and all of a sudden your body says, "Hey, we're running good. We're running on all 8 cylinders." And so then that's when it really is good. But people say, you know, they maybe take it for a month and sometimes they go, okay, you know, I did my little detox. It's good. I feel good. And then they go back to their other lifestyle. And guess what? You get loaded. It's kind of like you wash your car once. Hey, it looks good. But after that, it's like it goes and it gets dirty again. So you got to go out and wash the car again and keep it washed so you're looking good.
Well, and you know, that is true. We live in such an instant gratification society. You know, we want to do a diet pill and be thin by tomorrow for our day at the beach or something. But it doesn't work that way. It's not supposed to work that way. So when we look at that overall process, then we have to ask ourselves what's really important. And I think that's what I really like about your tea. It actually makes you ask the question. It's not just something you do. It's something you have to ask yourself, why am I doing it? And once we get to the why, then we get to something larger. And I do a whole seminar on just why, asking why it's so important. But how did this entire thing start anyway?
Well, basically, I got sick. You know, I was a talk show host, and I had a lot of listeners, and I kind of was, you know, complaining, oh, I don't feel good. And somebody said, you know, they actually sent me a bag of tea. And they said, you need to try this. And I'm like, tea? Are you kidding me? I mean, you know, like, forget this, you know. But, you know, I was so sick, I decided, I'll give it a try. Well, guess what? It worked. And then I thought, well, you know, I'd like to get this going. This could help my radio show. And so it went from there. And the next thing you know, I went with the doctor. I got a formula. And bam, we took off. And I started marketing. And next thing you know, it outgrew my radio show. So either I wasn't a good talk show host or the tea's much better. I don't know, but it all worked out good. And I still get to use radio skills to talk about the tea and different things and, you know, all of our garbage that's in our politics. And it makes it fun. So, you know, my life's good, except now my product helps people. And that's exciting because, you know, a lot of times when you buy a new product, you know, even a supplement, you start taking it, you don't see anything happen in 2 or 3 days. It takes, you know, sometimes weeks or months for things to start taking place when you're running low on some, maybe a supplement, maybe you're a vitamin C deficient, or maybe you're B12 deficient. So it takes a while to pick that up. The tea is kind of a different ball game. You make the tea, you have the now effect. People go, wow, it works right now. I drank it and I'm feeling different immediately. And that is exciting. You don't have to wait 30 days or 60 days or 90 days. It is within usually 2 or 3 days, sometimes within 1 day or even hours. So that's exciting.
Well, and you know, you mentioned something, then that was parasites and governments, and those two things kind of go hand in hand. But when it comes to parasites, we have this tendency to think that in America, in our Western culture, we don't have parasites. Parasites are something that only affect people in third world countries when they drink dirty water or whatever.
Yeah.
How much of a threat are parasites to the American / Western world?
How about 85%? 85%. Yeah. There is some kind of, I mean, think about this. You know, when we go and we eat uncooked meat, there's little crawlies there. But see, since we don't see worms in our meat, we go, oh, there's nothing there. I know, it's terrible. But it's true, and it's disgusting. I mean, you go and look on the internet some of this, the parasite. I mean, if I did that and used the fear factor, I'd sell more tea. I'd be out probably tomorrow because people don't like little things in their body. But what was really kind of interesting, and this was kind of a test for my tea, I kind of excited about this. You know, I have some challenges in health as well. Even though I'm Mr. Supplement Guy, Mr. Tea, you know, I kind of jacked up my body for a lot of years. And then all of a sudden, for 10 years, I've been doing good. So you still have to pay the price for all those jack up years. So long and short of that, well, maybe I have parasites. So I went out and I bought the best natural parasite, super duper cleanser, blah, blah, blah. You know, and it wasn't my formula. It was somebody else's. And I thought, you know, this will be a good thing. So I took this and guess what? I had no parasites. And this was exciting because I'm going, well, I drink the tea every day, so that's why I didn't have any parasites. So it was kind of another kicker to say, you know what, this tea is good for you because you don't want those little creepy crawly things attacking you. It gets inside of the organs. Let me tell you something, it'll jack you up. So you definitely want to be drinking some. And if you can drink something every day and be guaranteed you're not going to have parasites, it's kind of cool. So I don't know. I just think, you know, and again, not using the fear factor, but I don't like creepy crawlies.
Well, I don't either. Matter of fact, very few things gross me out. You know, I'm fine with horror movies and accident scenes, but thinking about a worm living in my gut or in my brain, that's enough for me to say, okay, let's end this. Let me drink some tea. I'll come back.
No, it's true. It's true. But you know, and I don't like to use fear. I like to use proactivity, you know. In other words, when we're proactive with our health, and this is so funny, we will go out as people and we'll look at Mercedes-Benz. We'll look at BMW. We'll look at Volvo. We'll look at all these high-end cars. Wow, I look good in that car. Yeah, that's going to really make my life different. And we'll, and there's nothing against a nice car, but we'll sabotage our body and go eat a Big Mac and some French fries, which is pure simple carbs, and jack our body up because we don't even know where that food came from. And we have no problem with that. So I find it funny, our investment, you know, if we're going to be a true entrepreneur, shouldn't we be an entrepreneur investing in ourself versus investing in garbage from somebody else? That's my thoughts.
Well, you're right. But the thing with that, just to play devil's advocate, the Mercedes makes us feel good. The Rolex makes us feel good. The $2,000 suit makes us feel good. And that Big Mac makes us feel good. Like, we've kind of become slaves to our tongue, where we really dictate what we eat based on how it tastes, not what it does for us.
Yes, yes. In fact, there's the little rumor that it doesn't taste good, it's good for you. You know, they basically rate if you have like if you have head lettuce, which is kind of a light color lettuce. Well, honestly, there's very little nutrition in a head of lettuce. But if you get something like red leaf or green leaf lettuce, the nutrition changes immensely. So if you have broccoli, it's super dark green, right? Well, immensely, it's huge for you. The only thing that doesn't fit into that is cauliflower. Cauliflower is probably the number one nutritious vegetable you can eat, and it's at the top.
Really?
Yes, and it's white. So I don't know what that is, but you know, it is what it is. And you, if you eat broccoli and cauliflower raw, just a little bit every day, let me tell you how you will change your system. I mean, you will feel different. Your digestion will change. We are not carnivores, we're herbivores. I know a lot of people don't want to hear that, but we truly are supposed to be eating vegetarian. We're not supposed to be eating meat. If you look at your hands, you don't have any big long claws. If you look at your teeth, you don't have big long fangs that are going to rip meat off of its bone. So we're not carnivores. But somehow in the chain, we've changed to carnivore. And I'll be honest, I like my meat too. But if we cut our meat back and we move our vegetables forward, your whole digestion system will change, and not in a bad way. You'll be like living life in a good way, and you'll live a lot longer too. That's even proven.
Well, and even the point of cutting meat back, because I'm not in the whole sort of vegan community where all the animals are crying because they lost their mom or whatever. I'm not, but we have become meat dominant. I admit that I'm at that mindset, and I'm trying to change it. But unless there's meat in a meal, I didn't eat. Like if I have a huge salad, it could be a massive salad, and 10 minutes later somebody said, hey, have you eaten yet? I would say, no, I haven't eaten yet. I had a salad, yeah, but I haven't eaten yet.
Yeah, no, that's true.
And it's just that mindset.
It is. It is a mindset. And if we change our mindset, you know, and you're talking to Mr. Meat Eater. You know, it's a wonder I don't run out there and grab the cow myself. You know, I mean, that's how bad I was. But, you know, I'm looking at it now, and I've been paying very close attention to my body. And, like, if I drink the tea, and all of a sudden I go a couple days and travel, and I don't have the tea, my body starts withdrawing. It starts saying, you know, what are you feeding me? If you grab a bag of Doritos, and you eat a bag of Doritos, do you ever wonder why you go, God, I ate that whole bag by myself? You know,
yes.
You feel guilty. I ate that whole, and here's another thing. So you eat the whole bag, right? And you're still freaking hungry. You're like, yeah, I could still eat, right? You know why? Because your body didn't recognize the Doritos as food. So what happens is your body says, I'm hungry. But if you eat a few vegetables or you eat something that's really good for you, your body says, thank you. And all of a sudden, you'll watch, you can eat like raw vegetables and you don't have to eat that many and you will be full and it will last.
Yeah, and that's where it comes down to those decision-making processes. You know, are you going to be full or are you going to be happy or not happy? That's the wrong word for it. Like, are we just eating for our taste buds? But, you know, when you mention something like the tea and the diet, I think that's why the tea is so important, because the honest truth is if somebody says, hey, you know, there's donuts in the break room, I mean a donut. So we have to do other things that kind of help us in that modality of saying, you know, it's not going to be 100% I'm going vegan tomorrow. That's probably not there. But that tea then allows you to say, hey, at least let's work towards it. And as your body feels better, I think it's easier for you to make those decisions that continue to make you feel better.
Well, let's call it what it is. And we all, and here is Mr. Supplement Guy, Mr. Tea Guy, okay, right here. It's live. I'm telling you, I cheat, okay? And everybody cheats. You go, I got to have a bowl of ice cream, man. I'm breaking down. I need it. I got to have it.
Right?
Okay. Is it good for you? No. You know, do you know where it's made? No. Is the milk pasteurized? Yes. And then it's bad for you. So we can go all this, you know, homogenized. Yeah, it's all bad. But we still break down. So what you just said is really big. So, yes, we're going to have those tendencies. But the tea will help us say, okay, you kind of put something in your body that's not that great for you. So I'll go ahead and I'll take it out. And what's cool about the tea is it leaves the good stuff. So if you go and have a vitamin C or you have something, you go have vegetables and all those vitamins that come with it, the tea will not take that out. It somehow, I don't know how herbs work, but it must be a God thing. But the herbs take out the bad guys and they leave the good guys. So this is why you do so well, is because the tea is only taking out the bad guys. So when you have Doritos, there's a lot of bad guys. They gotta fight. Boy, that's tiring to them. But when you're eating something good for you or semi-good for you, then you're good. There's some of these burger stands, if you do the research, they actually are trying very hard to put the right products in. So you still kind of get the good taste. In-N-Out Burger is a clear for this one. They have their own meat product, their own meat facility, so they don't like all the garbage in there. So, and there's other companies too. So if you research that, you can still have that burger taste that goes ooh ah ooh and still be halfway okay. But the tea will definitely make up the balance.
Well, speaking of balance and how the tea helps that, you know, something that's interesting to me is the cost of eating healthy. Whenever you talk about, well, in order to be healthy, it's extremely expensive, where the Doritos are only a buck, the dollar menu at the fast food thing is only a buck. But that's where something like the tea can help, because if you're consuming the tea, you take it in the morning, your body is feeling better, you're not wanting those cravings as much. And, you know, the reality is, for some reason, yeah, something that organically grew for thousands of years that you could just go around the road and pick and eat has now become more expensive than a cow. That takes a fortune to. So what's behind that? Do you know?
Well, here's how I look at it: is the tea is something that, you know, it runs $35 for a bag of tea. So people go, oh my God, but that $35 is a month worth of tea. So if you break it down, it's about a dollar a day, depending on how you drink it. Some people go 45 days on a month's supply, depending on how much they're drinking. So really a buck a day to change your lifestyle is really good. It's really important to understand that the tea is for your benefit and you have to be proactive. You have got to be thinking proactive, because if you're not proactive, then you're going to be in trouble.
And at a dollar a day, I mean, when you look at things like Starbucks, $3, $4, $5, $6
Yeah, a whack.
A dollar a day becomes cheap. And that's the other thing, you know, and that's why balance is so important. If a dollar a day is too expensive for you, you might want to look at other areas of your life and say, hey, wait a second, where am I out of balance? Am I spending $90 on cable television every month and I don't watch it? You know, what else is it making you look at?
How about $5 to $6 for a beer? How about $4 or $5 for a pack of cigarettes? We can go on and on and on. And let me tell you something. And here's something that's very interesting too, and people might not know. The big boy companies, okay, you're gonna find sugar, and you need to become a reader. You just take that product you're buying that you go, wow, I really like this, turn it around and say, how many sugars are in there? And you're gonna find things like spices with sugar. You're gonna find things. You're going to find all kinds of sugar additives in things that there shouldn't be any sugar. You're also, another one is interesting to look for is wheat. Wheat is in so many different sauces. In fact, I found this out because I'm gluten intolerant. I go to a Mexican restaurant and I say, by the way, you know, in your red sauce, is there any wheat? And they'll go, oh yeah. So then I go, oh, now I would have never known that. So I'm going to have these cheese enchiladas, which should be good for gluten-free, except there's wheat in the sauce. So you have to start looking. And why are they doing that? That's a whole conspiracy thing, or that's a whole reality thing, and that's a whole thing to explore someday. But what's interesting is when you start looking at sugar, and here's a fact on sugar. Sugar, and this is wild, sugar, this is a proven fact, is more addictive than cocaine. More addictive than cocaine. So when you have, and this is my rule. My rule is if you want to kick in sugar and do better, 72 hours is what it takes. Because if you ever notice when you have whatever, it doesn't matter what your, you know, pie or cake or whatever, and you eat it, okay, the next day what happens? You're ready to eat it again. Or maybe even that morning, you're ready to eat it again. Hey, maybe I'll have another piece of pie right before I go to work. You know, no big deal. Have some coffee and pie, right? Right? Yeah. Because what happens? You're now addicted. You take 72 hours, and guess what? Your cravings will be gone. 72 hours without sugar, and your craving will be gone. And you won't be going, oh, look at that pie. You'll look at the pie, and you'll go, yeah, I know what that tastes like. It's good, but you won't have that, oh, I got to have it. You'll have that, no big deal. I might have it later, but you won't have it later. So it's really 72 hours is the magical number.
So how then, I have no clue that you could turn around spices and find sugar. Without going too deep down that rabbit trail, how are sugars ending up everywhere, including in spices? And I've even heard fast food chains have sprayed their lettuce with sugar to make it addictive.
Yes.
But how is it ending up everywhere?
Pardon me?
How is it ending up everywhere?
Well, this is my opinion. Sugar is addictive. So addicted, if we're addicted to something, are we going to buy it again? If you're addicted to Doritos, you're not going to buy one bag. You're going to buy three bags, right? You're not going to buy 1 ounce or 5 ounces. You're going to buy a pound. So it's all about selling, okay? This is the MSG thing. If it tastes good, MSG is so bad for you. So if it tastes good, and this goes with corn fructose syrup, which is totally a GMO product. Here's the scary thing. Did you know that we almost don't have any real corn left that is so genetically modified that if we wanted real corn, then we couldn't have it? Did you know that 70% of your grocery store is GMO? 70%. Now, if you looked at all the labels, it wouldn't say on any of the labels, oh, by the way, this has GMO products. I will commend Coca-Cola. When you go on Coca-Cola's website, scroll down, it says we use GMO products. Okay? Well, at least they're honest. Okay. I may not like that, but at least they're honest. Okay. But there's a lot of products. You might buy some tomato sauce and you go, oh, it doesn't say anything here. We're good to go. But that really not saying anything means that it's a GMO product, which means break this down, which means you have a man-made organism that is being put into your God-made organism, and the two don't connect, and it jacks the insides up. And what's interesting is people don't understand that, and when they don't understand that, they keep doing it. So imagine that ugly thing that you wanted to shut the show down, parasites, right? Little crawly things.
Yes.
There we go again, right? So we're putting man-made stuff in God-made stuff, and it's not meant to do that. That's a fact.
Wow. So, okay, then who should be taking the tea? So somebody's listening to this and, okay, I hear you talking about tea. I hear you talking about parasites. Who's supposed to take this?
Everyone. You know, if people go, can I give it to my kids? I go, yeah. But, you know, you don't want to be doing 16 ounces with your four-year-old. You know what I'm saying? Because his poor insides will be cramping, you know. So you cut it down. You bring it to maybe 4 ounces a day, you know. And as they get older, 6 ounces, 8 ounces a day. And most people go, okay, 16 ounces a day. I'll be honest, I don't drink 16 ounces a day. You can, but it's fine. If you're doing a real cleanse, 16 ounces is good. But as a normal base, like if you're going to do this every month and keep your body all tuned up, you could do, I do 12 ounces at night and none in the morning. It's because it's 2 8s, 1 8 in the morning, 1 8 at night. But I'll do 12 because then there's no bathroom problems because you're good to go. And if there was a bathroom problem, you're catching at night, not at work where you got to, oh my gosh, where's the bathroom? Oh my God, yeah. So once you get going, everything is good. So, everybody, and I have people that are elderly. I have people that are young. I have female. I've met people say, oh, well, that's a girl thing. Yeah, that's a female thing. And I go, really? Well, then how come I have so many men ordering this tea? And let me tell you something else for those people that really want to hear something fun. If you got, I call it an L60. If you've got a spare tire going on around the old middle there, this tea will help you. Okay. And that spare tire will kind of come down a little bit. When I first started my tea 10 plus years ago, I lost 25 pounds in 3 months. And whoa, that wasn't fat. That was gross stuff that shouldn't be in my body.
You're just grossing everybody out today. Between the stuff that's not supposed to be in there and the parasites.
Gross. Well, again, I think we talked about this. John Wayne had 70 pounds of sludge in his body when he died. 70 pounds. Now, my question would be, and I can't prove this, I'm not a doctor, but I wonder how long he would have lived if that 70 pounds of sludge was clean. Because what happens is your colon gets clogged and your organs can't feed off of what nothing. It's kind of like putting a hand over your mouth. So that's the difference, right?
And even things like, you know, cancers and all that sort of stuff, we're supposedly cleaner now. There's fewer people smoking, fewer people, you know, painting cars without ventilators, all that sort of stuff. We took all these safety hazards. But yet cancer's now 1 in 2 or 1 in 3, where back when everybody was smoking, it was 1 in like 200. I remember even when I was young, cancer was still so rare, they had to tell us that it wasn't communicable by touch or something. And now everybody and their brother has it, and I think it has a lot to do with what you're talking about.
Absolutely. Josh, did you hear what you said? We're cleaner now. We have more safety in going on, and now it's 1 in 2. Where we were painting cars with nothing on us, we were painting with asbestos, putting stuff up, right? We're doing all this stuff. And yes, people are sick, but not at the rate they are today. So is it really those issues that they put safety on? Or is it something else, like maybe what they're doing to our water, air, and food? Maybe there's something that connects there.
Well, so let's talk about that a little bit. I mean, if it's in our air and our water, not just our food, do you recommend that people make the tea with distilled water? Or, yeah, I mean, certainly tap water in some places like Flint, Michigan, you don't want to use that with anything.
I think the tea needs to be done with the cleanest water you can buy, and that is not bottled water. Do your studies on bottled water. It is absolutely the worst. In fact, some of the people's tap water is better than bottled water. That's a whole nother show. That's a whole nother subject. But long and the short of it is you want to do your best with filtered water that's clean. Just so you know, the some of the waters out there, they clean the water so good, and especially the filtered waters, that they take out everything, and then your water is hungry water and it actually will hurt your body. But you want to get the best water you can. But some people, and this is why I don't really go that direction a lot, is because some people don't have access to it because maybe they just have enough money for the tea, or maybe they just have enough, you know. So I understand those people, and that's why I try to put specials together so that they can save some money, because some people are on such a limited budget. And I understand that. But if you have the money, you want to have filtered water as much as you can, and you want to have the tea. And that's going to help you from all the stuff that's going on in the air. Just so you know, the tea helps with heavy metals. What are we getting in the air? Aluminum and barium. Okay, so this helps take this stuff out. Okay, will it take 100% out? Probably not, but it will definitely, you know, anything you can do to help you take stuff out is a good thing.
Well, and, you know, even from a financial standpoint, whether it's right or wrong, it's irrelevant. It just is. Healthy people make more.
Yes.
And people who are less overweight make more. There's just this subconscious mental stigma against overweight people. So if you were to say, hey, I can't afford the tea, I'm not making enough, health actually has been proven time and again to help you get jobs, get raises, get promotions. And that's not even talking about the confidence level that comes with not having that spare tire around your stomach.
Absolutely. When I lost the 25 pounds, it made me go, you know what? I need to incorporate exercise. And then it also made me go, you know what? I need to change some of my meals. You know, I try to have one meal a day that's just totally vegetarian. Again, you're talking about a guy that might tackle the cow and eat it. So, you know, I do want my meat. But I learned that, you know what? I can have my meat, but instead of doing a 16-ounce steak, I'll do a 6-ounce steak. You know, and what happens is, because you have no idea, there's a lot of carbs in meat. So we have to realize what we're eating. And so you can still have it. This goes back to cheating. You can have a little bit of ice cream, or you can have a little bit of cake or pie, but just have it once a week or twice a week. Don't have it seven times a week. And what happens is you get proactive, you're going to start losing weight, you're going to feel better. And we haven't even touched on, Josh, the mind, because the mind is the center and the hub of health. And that is huge, because they're now coming out with clinical studies, which are kind of being, they've been buried. And there's clinical studies that proves that the mind can change and, ready for this, heal the body.
Oh, actually, not only am I ready for that, I've been teaching that for 21 years. There have been cases, because think about this, for real, think about this. Most people don't understand. Your body replaces every cell in its body, everything. You are not the same person you were 7 years ago. Every cell has changed, which means your mind replaced that scar. You regrew the scar. And there's no scientific reason for that to happen other than your mind purposely saying, oh, that's where the scar goes. Let's regrow it. There have been people with split personalities where one personality needed medication, the other personality didn't. Your mind is extremely powerful. And I completely agree. If that's getting cluttered up and muddied down, it's not going to operate as effectively as it should be and could be. So, yeah, absolutely, I'm on board with you there.
Well, and here's one, too. Are you ready for this? Our diets, okay? And I should bet, let me change that. Our new diets, okay? Not the one that you might, after this show, try to grab, but the one that you might be on right now, which is a lot of simple carbs, a lot of sugar, that's the new diet, okay? It's taking and changing the neural pathways in our brain, dumbing us down, and make it to where people are getting Parkinson's, or they're getting all of these diseases at 50 years old instead of 70 or 80 years old, because we've changed our diet, because we are high sugar a high sugar diet. And we are not meant to have a high sugar diet. When we do grains are simple carbs turn to sugar. So now we have sugar plus sugar plus sugar, and we're not meant to run like that. So when we change our diet, we start actually changing our brain waves. And the next thing you know, you start thinking clearer. So when you're talking about an entrepreneur, you're talking about making more money, or talking about how you feel and losing weight, it's all about brain waves. Tell me, who gets the job? The guy that says, I can't really do it. I'm really kind of tired. Or the guy that says, you know, I want to get this job. I'm going to go in. I'm going to let it go. And they're going to hire me. This is going to be great. Which one gets the job?
Oh, absolutely. And now we're seeing people in their 40s get dementia. I mean, that used to be something that was for the 80s and overs. And now that it's happening to people in their 40s. And, you know, even when you were talking about balance and everybody cheats, I forgot what I was watching, some documentary. But he was talking about something similar where we used to have sugar, like Thanksgiving, grandma would make a pie. And then maybe on your birthday, you'd have a cake. That was it. But now we have sweet stuff so available to us. Anytime you go to the gas station, they have a donut rack. You know, anytime you go into even a health food store, there's candy bars near the checkout. Yep. So we have sugar everywhere. Whereas our ancestors, it was a special treat to where, okay, fine, you have it. It's not going to do that much damage because you had it 2-3 times a year, maybe on festivals or holidays.
And I feel that this is, you're dead on, and I feel this is all set up by someone, I'll say, we'll leave it at that, that is getting us to get into this diet that makes us really lethargic. It's easy to control you, Josh, and this is how I see it. It's easy to control you if I give you something and you're not at your 100%. So now we're going to go and we're going to box in a boxing ring, but you had Twinkies, so you got a high, and boy, you hit the low right when you got in the ropes. Who's going to win that fight? Even if you're stronger than me, who's going to win that fight? It's going to be the guy that's on his top deal. And this is where I go, I think sometimes this is even planned, because when you go in a grocery store, I mean, it's just like you said, the front aisles, the side aisles, they're all set up for sugar products. They're all set up for Twinkies and Hostess cupcakes and ice cream. Yep. And they're always on sale. They always all 50 cents off of your Twinkies. You know, oh boy, I'm going to buy some of that. And we wonder why when we die, we don't rot away for about 20 years.
Well, and you know, just because I know who our audience is, there's a lot of people who are into prepping and getting ready for whatever they think is coming and, political chaos. I don't care how many bullets you have. If you can't run up a flight of stairs, you're dead. Like, it's amazing to me how many people, I got to lose a few pounds too. But it's amazing how these people will spend a fortune on, $2,700 ham radio kits and $7,000 worth of ammunition. But when it comes to a dollar a day for tea, they won't even think about, I need to be healthy. Yeah, you need to be healthy. Why do you think even in the military, what's your first stop? It's not how to disarm a bomb. It's boot camp because we got to get you in shape.
Yes, yes. Way good point. Big, huge. Blink lights, put neon over it. That's a huge thing. I made a commercial on the tee one time and said, I watch people and they vest in gold and precious metals. And I think that's a good thing. But what good is all those precious metals and you fill up your wheelbarrow full of metals when you can't even lift the wheelbarrow because you're so sick? What good is it?
Exactly. Man, it is crazy how fast 30 minutes goes when I'm talking to you.
So I'm a blabber.
Let's do this. How do people get the tea? Obviously, everybody's just going to get it. Everybody who's watching this, if they can count to two, they know they need to get the tea. How do they get the tea?
GetTheTea.com. I made it so simple. That way that, they're driving to the car. I forgot the website. Oh, yeah, I got to get the tea. .com. I got to get the tea.com. I get it. So GetTheTea.com. You go to the front page. I mean, I got all kinds of stuff because I'm always searching how to make the body better. And not only I can't do everything, okay? I can only help the people. I mean, there's even if you scroll on the front page, you can go down. I've even got somebody to have bad backs. There's a whole video system that you can get so that it'll help you decompress your back so that if you have blown discs, you can do better. So I do everything I can to help the body, but it's getthetea.com. You scroll down, our specials are going to be on the front. We actually have a specials page where I put different things together so you can bundle up goods so you're going to get healthy and save money. So I understand what it's like to be on that budget. I do. I lived that for so long, so I get it. So I'm trying very hard because I want people healthy. And if you say, Ronnie, I don't have a lot of money, what would you say is the number one thing I should get? If I have a little bit of money, what would you say? And I'd say, getthetea.com.
Getthetea.com. I think that should be everything.com. Your dot-com-ness was brilliant. It needs to just be, getevangelpreneur.com or whatever.
Yes,
that's awesome.
Yes.
So next time, because I want people to know there is going to be a next time. Next time, can we go down one of these rabbit trails and get to the who is the they that did this in the first place?
Oh, if you really want to go there, I will take you there. And you know all this anyway, Josh. So we're just going to be bantering back and forth with they and them. But I like exposing they and them because their minds are so small. I always tell them, because they're watching this anyway. I always say, hey, guys out there, get the tea. Because maybe that will clean all their toxins out so they can do better and they can think better because they're not thinking right. You know that when you turn on the news and you see our political soap opera, they're not thinking right. So they need to get the tea probably more than any of the listeners.
Well, it's funny you say that. I do the radio show 5 days a week, and once in a while I actually refer to the poor little NSA guy that gets assigned to having to listen to my show. His imaginary girlfriend, I give him discounts on things and everything. So, yeah, they're listening. It just happens. But anyway, getthetea.com, getthetea.com. What was the website again?
I think it's, getthetea.com.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was. Ronnie McMullen, always a blast talking to you, buddy. We'll have to do it again soon.
All right, Josh, thanks.
All right, everybody, I'm out of here. I will see you next time. Remember, Josh Tully Show Monday through Friday. On a station near you, we just added a bunch of other new stations, so check your local listings. And I will see you next time.
All right, buddy. I appreciate it.